Let's integrate x times cosine of phi x. We can try to use the u substitution. Maybe we can say that u is equal to phi x. But then the derivative of phi x is just a 5. We cannot cancel all the x right here. So the u substitution wouldn't work for us. But it's okay, because we also have another tool called the integration by parts. The integration by parts says if we have the integral in the form of u dv, then we can get uv minus integral of v du. And what this is saying is that we have to look at the original integral and pick something for u and then the other for dv. The u that you choose, you are going to differentiate that. The dv that you choose, you are going to integrate that. Let's get to work. So I'm going to pick u right here. I'm going to write down dv right here. And we have two choices, namely x and cosine phi x. Technically, you should consider what you should put down for dv, because the things that you put down for dv, we have to integrate that. We must make sure to choose something that we know how to integrate for dv. Okay? In this case, you can choose x for dv, cosine of x for dv, because we can easily integrate both of these things. But then we are actually going to choose cosine of phi x for dv in this situation. And technically, I also have to attach dx because we have to talk about differentials, okay? And because I chose cosine phi x to be dv, I'm going to choose x for the u. And the reason why is because this is pretty easy to integrate. But then the advantage is having x right here. When we differentiate this equation, we get du. Du will be just 1 times dx. So as you can see, originally you had the function like x, but now once you differentiate that, you just get a constant, the 1, okay? And this is also pretty easy to do. Let's integrate both sides. We can get v. And the integral of cosine, it's going to be sine. But then because the inside is phi x, we have to look at the derivative of phi x, which is 5. We have to divide it by 5. V will be 1/5 sine, and we keep the inside the same. Okay? This part, technically, we're doing the u substitution for cosine of phi x. You let u is equal to phi x, and then you will see we have to multiply by 1/5 for this. But then the way I like to do it is just write down an answer right here, and then differentiate this real quick. The derivative of sine phi x will give you cosine phi x. But then you have to multiply by 5. That 5 will be canceled out with 1/5, so you have just 1 for that. We have the ingredients to do the integration by parts. It says I have to multiply uv's together, so the u is x, I'm going to multiply by v, which is that. Namely, I'm multiplying x times 1/5 sine of phi x. And I just put down 1/5 x sine of phi x, okay? I multiply these two together, I just put an x in the middle. And then we have to subtract an integral, subtract the integral, phi. Phi is 1/5 sine of phi x. So I put this down right here. Du is dx, right? Du is the same as dx. So we have that dx right here. And as you can see, the first part, it's the part of the answer already. There's no more integrations. But then this is still another integral that we have to work out. But this is not that bad, because this is just a number, 1/5. I can take the 1/5 outside, okay? And then I'm pretty much just rewrite this like a couple more times. Okay, so I'll just copy this down right here. But then I take out the 1/5. I'm just looking at the integral of sine of phi x. Integral of sine will give you negative cosine, but then inside here you have a phi x, so you multiply by 1/5 and you keep the phi x the same. So the integral of this is negative 1/5 cosine phi x. And we are done. There's no more integration that we need to do. The answer is the first part stays the same, 1/5 x times sine of phi x. And then the second part is negative times negative becomes positive. 1/5 times 1/5, we have the 1/25 cosine of phi x right here. We are done with the function part, and I just attach a plus c at the end. This is the answer. So box it. That's it.